Namaste children, a teacher-student relationship is similar to the relationship between a lapidary and a gem. A lapidary engrave a gem, whereas a teacher engrave a student and make them worthy enough. Our concept is based on relationship in a circle. Are you thinking of the topic, children? Today we are going to see the relationship between the diameter and the circumference of a circle. Are you ready? Now let us see how to find the relationship between circumference and diameter. For this, I am going to use two circular objects. That is, one is bangle, the other one is metal box. First, let us take the bangle. We know that bangle is in the shape of a circle. And here, where is the circumference? This is your circumference, that is the distance around the circle. Now let us see how to find the circumference using the thread. So I am taking a thread, and from here I am measuring. Okay children, you can take any other circular objects also. So here, if I measure, and after measuring, I am going to measure it thread using the scale. So starting from zero, you see where does this thread ends? It ends at 21. So wait, what is your circumference now? It is 21 centimeter. Now let us measure the diameter. So diameter starts from one point, passes through the center and ends at another point on the circle. So this is your diameter. You can keep like this or this, anyway. So here I am measuring the diameter, and what I am going to do is I am going to keep a mark. Now let us measure up to this mark. So now starting from zero, you see children, what is your diameter now? It is 7 centimeter. Now at this point I am going to cut the piece. Again I am measuring the diameter, place the mark. Now you measure the next. Again it is 7 centimeter, okay, and I am cutting from this also, so two parts. Now you measure the remaining parts also, it is 7, okay. So how many pieces we got? 1, 2, 3 pieces we have got, that is 7 plus 7 plus 7, that is equal to 21 centimeter. That 21 centimeter is your circumference. Now can we write the circumference as 3 into 7? That is 3 times 7. This 7 is your diameter, that is 3 into diameter. Now you got the relationship between circumference and diameter. 3 times your diameter makes your circumference. Now what will be your diameter? Diameter will be circumference divided by 3. If you what is your circumference? 21 divided by 3. 21 divided by 3 is 7 centimeter, that is your diameter. Got it? So these two formulas helps you to understand the relationship between circumference and diameter. Now let us try using the metal box. The same procedure. I have taken a thread, and measure. After measuring, you take the scale and find out the circumference starting from 0. You see where does this point stand? It is at 19. Okay, so here your circumference is 19 centimeter. Now, if you want to find the diameter, what is the formula? Already we have found out circumference divided by 3. That is equal to 19 divided by 3. If you divide 19 by 3, you see 6 threes are 18. Here remaining is 1. And if I add 0, here I will be putting point. That 0 you have to bring down. 3 threes are 9. So it goes on. That is 6 points 3 something. Okay. So here we can't take the diameter in decimals. So we are taking the value closer to 6. That is, you have to take the value 6 approximately. So in this case, we are using the word approximately. So when you write the formula, circumference equal to 3 into diameter, it is approximately in some cases. That is, if decimal comes, we will not be taking the decimal points. So in that case, we will be taking the approximate value. And here also, circumference divided by 3 approximately. Understood, children? Children, what do you learn from this circumference? Life may be circular, but its circumference keeps getting wider for us to grow. Hope you have enjoyed this video. Thank you, children.